Stop sniffing. It's what you get when you don't close your door properly. At least he's clean this time, so there's that. Well, hello my beauties and welcome to my channel. Today I am sitting in front of you with a naked face. Because I got some new goodies yesterday that I want to try out. I don't have a new foundation just yet, although I am really eyeing the... We got IT Cosmetics here in the Netherlands now. I have a coupon and I'm really wanting to try out the IT Cosmetics foundation, the normal one. And I'm also eyeing the Anastasia Beverly Hills foundation. So those will probably come, I don't know when. But anyway, the reason I don't have any foundation on just yet is because I got a setting powder. So let me kind of tell you real quick what I got. I was in Alkmaar yesterday and Kiko Milano had a very, very nice sale going on. Very nice sale. So I got some stuff from that. I got two eye pencils. These are called the Intense Color Long Lasting Eyeliner. And I got two colors. I got the color 11, which is a very dark teal. And it is... I really want to use this one today. It's so pretty and so soft and creamy. It's just insane. This one is the color 07 and it is a green that I didn't have actually. I have something like this but lighter. But it is such a pretty, I don't know, it's such a pretty formula that I really wanted to try these two. And these two were the colors that grabbed my attention the most. I got an eyeshadow base. I did not even know they had an eyeshadow base, but I got their eyeshadow base as well. That I want to try out today. It's in the color neutral. Then I got their setting powder. It's the Invisible Touch Face Fixing Powder. It looks like this. And it comes with this that I will not use. I think, I don't know. Yeah, but the powder itself... felt so nice and soft that I really wanted to try it. And I also got their Waterflower Magic Perfecting Powder. I have my skin finish from Revolution that I love very, very much. That one has kind of a golden shift, but I'm still, I don't know, looking around. And this one was so pretty. So this is what the compact looks like. It's a very soft pink. It is translucent. I don't even know if I want to use it because look how pretty. Oh, I don't know if it will show because it's white. But the embossing on it, I hope you can see it. The embossing on it is so, so pretty. And it has a sheen. That was, I don't really see it, but maybe it will pick up with a brush better than with my hand. She's very florally, so I'm going to leave it open. If you like that kind of thing, then yeah. That was it, I believe. I'm going to put on some foundation. I am going to wear my Catrice foundation because I know how that one performs, you know? So that I can really test out the powders. So let me put on my foundation and then I will be back before I'm going to set my face. So yeah. Okay. So, what I usually do first is set my under eyes. So let's do that after I have removed some hairs from my face. What I'm going to do actually is I'm going to tip it, I hope. And then see what happens. It's not the best packaging though. Well, not a lot happens. I have some here on the stuff thing. And on my hand, I see. It's very, very fine. Looks nice. It feels set, so that is good. So let me set then the rest of the face. Let me just do it like this. Just put my brush in. And I always start there where I know I'm going to put product. So where I'm putting my bronzer, my blush and such. So this brush from BH fits perfectly into that container, so that's good. It instantly mattifies though. But it also feels like it's kind of set, so that is good because I tend to overpowder in winter. But I really used a tiny, tiny amount. And this brush, as I said, from BH fits in perfectly. This is from their Rose Gold set. It's their number 2. Okay. What I'm going to do now, though, before anything else, is put on eyeshadow primer so that it has a little time to set and such. I actually usually do that, well, I try to do that before I powder my face. It has already set, guys, and it feels so soft. Wow. Okay, then. I don't really know. Usually I have something with a dough. Oh, that's a lot. Usually I have something with a dough foot, so I don't really know how I want to apply this. Let's grab a brush to blend it out. I think I grabbed too much. And this is the reason I usually do it before powder, or try to, because I like to use it underneath my eyes as well. Let's grab my sponge to dab. Okay, so note to self, I think I need to use it the same as I use my glitter primer, actually. What it doesn't do, and that's what I kind of looking for, is it doesn't make my eyes look crimpy and dry. If I use, for instance, my MAC Paint Pot now, it really, I don't know, it emphasizes every texture that I have in my eyelids. So yeah, it does feel sticky already, which is good. I do want it set a tiny bit just there. So let me grab this guy again. I want a tiny bit just on the bone. And this brush is too big for that, but yeah. I'm just using the tip. That's what she said. So fun. Okay. So there is that. Now I don't know if it will dry down on its own or what. Let's use... do I do that now or later? I will do it later like a buffing powder, I think. Yes. Face is set, so yeah, let's get some bronzer. I have here my Maybelline City Bronzer. And you know what? Let's use this one as well, which is the Revolution Sunlight Mood Light Highlighter / blush. I've been really liking this again, so let me put those on really quickly. Stop sniffing. If you hear weird noises, well, weirder than normal, licking and such, one of my cats is down here, the same one that was in my Let's Talk Makeup video. I will link it down below. That's what you get when you don't close your door properly. The powders blended nicely over each other. My face feels set, even though I used a very, very tiny amount. And I don't know, it almost gives me kind of a lid from within look. Now that I've kind of buffed over it a little bit. So far, I really like that powder. So let's use the stinky one then. Let's use my fluffy brush that I like to use for the... It is very, very pretty though. It's very hard. That's what she said. Okay. Wow, it's actually really pretty, guys. At least I think so. I am... very impressed, actually. My under eyes are set. They don't feel dry. And again, I used such a small amount. This stinky powder, which looks very, very pretty, but I'm going to leave open. If I swatch it, nothing really happens. But when I put it on my face, I think it's really, really pretty. I will leave all the products down below, though. But... Invisible Touch Face Fixing Powder. I hate the packaging, but so far, I'm actually really impressed. Which does not happen a lot with powders, especially setting powders. I am obviously going to keep on playing with them more, and I will let you know how I get along with them. What do you want, my child? Well, actually, it's my child's cat, but yeah. Who's counting? Yeah, je bent lief. Eyeshadow. Because I actually really want to use this one. I think this is so, so, so pretty. Because I want to use it, let's just put it on. I look ridiculous. But that's not the first time. I have here 2 palettes from Ace Beauty. The Oceanic and the Flare. Because in the Oceanic, there's a color that I want to pair with this. So... let me get a brush and do that. So I'm going to basically start with my bottom lashes today. So I have my Morphe E36 here. I'm going to smudge it a little. Okay, I'm going to grab the color Marina from the Oceanic, which is very close to this color. I'm going to spray it and I'm going to... I can find my spray. And I'm going to put that on top of the lower lash line. Of course I create massive fallout, I forgot. Let's grab it a little bit higher here. I want to blend a little bit more underneath my eye. And I'm actually going to grab the color called Seaweed, this one. Blends over the eyeshadow primer very, very nicely, by the way. So, let's get my blending brush. I'm going back into the color Seaweed with the brush that I am using now. Now, because this is kind of a dirty brown, green, whatever, usually those shades are kind of difficult, at least for me, to blend or grab. What do I want with an eyeshadow primer? I want both. I want it to grab, but I also want to be able to blend without really needing to set it. But if I do set it, I still want it to be able to grip my shadow. This seems to do so very, very nicely. And I did set here the top part. Okay, what I'm going to do now is grab my face powder. And I'm grabbing just a pressed face powder. I'm going to run it over here just to soften the edges extra. So I clean the brush. I am going to go into the color called Jellyfish, that one. It's going to go in the inner part of my eye. And I'm going to kind of connect it to that brownie matte. Okay, and then I'm going to grab my skin finish because of that goldeny shift that it has. And it's going to go my inner corner. Okay. That is it so far, I think. So let me finish off the look with liner, lashes and the lippy. And then I will be back and we can kind of discuss a little bit of the products that I used today. So hold on tight, don't go anywhere. Everything is on and here is the finished look. For lip, I used the Catrice Mad Lover lip pen in Top It with Cinnamon. It is a skinny lipstick. It's the only brown that they have in this line, I believe. But it's really nice, it's really comfortable. So yeah, I like it. I think I can be pretty quick about everything that I tried today from Kiko Milano. The powder, I really like the powder. And the only other time that I said that was when I got the Hourglass powder. Because, yes, setting powders for me are kind of setting powders. This, it feels soft. It feels like my skin. Let me look at it, especially my eyes. My face does not look cakey. My under eyes look like my under eyes. So let me tone down the light. Where is it? A little bit. Is that that way? Yes, and zoom in so you can see what I'm seeing. So it does not look cakey, especially here underneath my eyes. It looks nice. Oh no. Let me zoom you out before you are very, very scared to death.
My hair is all fucked up. That was almost the table.
Oh no. So that happened. At least he's clean this time. So there's that. But yeah, the powder looks really, really nice. Let me turn up the light again. The way this should be. I really like this powder. I don't really like the application. The puff thing that is with it. I probably won't use this. On the other hand, maybe it is nice to press in. Maybe I will try it. But maybe then, like, sometimes I have a dry beauty sponge to press in everything. Sometimes when I don't want to use a lot of powder, but I have a thicker foundation that maybe needs a little bit more powder, I use a dry sponge, especially in summertime. I do that a lot to press everything really in, you know. Maybe I will use it for that. Because I don't know. I will try it and let you know. But yeah, so far I really like the powder. I think it looks pretty. And it also had kind of almost a sheen. It wasn't, when I first put it, it was weird. But when I first put it on, it mattified. And then when I kind of blended over it, it gave that glow like the Hourglass powder does. This one is even finer and lighter though. So yeah. I'm very impressed with that powder. Okay, the next, let's go to the next powder then, the stinky one. Yeah, she smells florally. Now that I have kind of removed the top layer a little bit, I can see the pearlescent in it. When I swatch it, it's very underwhelming. But then when I put it on the face, whew, very, very pretty. It looks so cute. It comes with a mirror. The only downside is it has a floral scent. So if you don't like that, I'm just going to leave it open. It's not very, very overwhelming. Like, for instance, the Ame bronzer that I got in a BoxyCharm or in a subscription box. Oh, that was so nauseatingly scented. This is scented, but yeah, I need to kind of put my nose in. So I'm going to leave it open and... So it can kind of air out. But I think it's very, very pretty. It did not disrupt anything. So yeah, I'm happy about that. The primer. It gripped my makeup. It blended out. Or my eyeshadow. I could blend over it. It did not make my eyes dry. And that is half the battle won for me. If I'm being completely honest. I kind of think I did use a little bit too much. So next time I will use it like I use my NYX Glitter Primer. I will just directly put it on top of a brush. And then apply it. But yeah, I don't know how shadows will last on it because I have not. I don't know just yet. The eye pencil, yeah, they're just so pretty. These were the two colors that spoke to me the most. They're very, very soft. They glide on without any effort, which is a good thing and a bad thing because you can kind of, what I did, go too low too quickly, you know? But yeah, I made it work in the end anyway. So yeah. That was it. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. If you are new here, hi, my name is Nikki. I did not say that in the beginning, I think. Hi, I'm Nikki. I'm Dutch and older. I'm almost 44. I'm going to be 44 this year. My main focus is colorful makeup like I have on today. However, I am discovering my more neutral side. So if you would like to join my discovering neutrals journey and testing out stuff and just having fun with makeup, hit the subscribe button if you haven't done so already. For now, I'm going to thank you so much for watching. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, fabulous evening, and I will see you very soon in my next one. Bye guys.